During this lecture, we'll be discussing clinal variation. The traditional definition is the geographic or the graded variation in a population, and we'll be explaining that using examples. First of all, the height variation of a plant, and we're going to be seeing this graph in the next slide. The height variation of a plant versus the altitude it is present in, essentially what we see here is that the higher the altitude, the shorter the plant, and this is going to be showing in the differences in the frequencies of the alleles the higher the altitude we go. So basically this changes occur because of the adaptations, the adaptive capacity of the plant to its altitude. Now what we are seeing here is, just like we mentioned before, the higher the altitude that we are present in, the shorter the plant is going to be. There's another type of variations that can occur between the members of the same population and also in the same area. Like the previous example we mentioned was the same population but different areas. Now we have the same population at the same area but at different times. So this is the difference here, and this is called variation in time or temporal variation. Now, population variation inclines. Obviously, clinal variation is a continuous variation because the higher we go in altitude, the shorter the plant. And this can occur for many organisms. It does not only refer to plants. Many changes can occur depending on the temperature, depending on the altitude, etc. Now, assuming and this also follows a gradual change, like the higher the altitude, the shorter the plant. However, some changes can occur and these do not follow a certain pattern, and these are called discontinuous variations. Now, a question can be raised, and that is, how can we explain clines? Basically, like, such patterns can arise from the selective pressure. Like, at different altitudes, these plants have to have different heights in order to adapt to its environment. Now, so it's selective pressure that differ from one region to another. Usually these clines are associated with changes in the environment, like these changes in the environment that are going to be triggering essentially the natural selection to occur, and these are going to be based on humidity, temperature, availability, etc. Now, worth noting that the example we actually mentioned before is that obviously the higher we go in altitude, generally speaking, the lower the temperature. So the previous example was based on temperature, and therefore it's called a thermal cline.